became very, very aware of the fact that I'm from Galway. And I have always been interested in my family tree, but I decided to go back even more. And I've been researching, and I've gone back six generations, and I am at least six generations on all strains of my family tree, Galwegian. So I've been very much, I mean, I was very much almost dreaming about these people. I was in the time, and I felt very warm, and I feel very safe dreaming, but it doesn't feel spooky to me at all.
After the moment you're shot down, like a haze and juicing drown, will you eat humble pie and turn a blind eye? And oh, now the elephant's in the room, fairy tale is askew, and kind words can only frame the rough and tumble of a harsh game. You thought was music to your ears before it was revealed that you're not in the role of gatekeeper. But after you
remember my grandfather?
I sure do, John Feeney, yeah.
And do you remember what was he like?
Oh, he was all the Feeneys were tall and bony. They were kind of big, strong men, they were.
And do you remember his father, Johnny?
I remember the morning he died. The word went around that John Feeney was dead. But other than that, I didn't know much about him, but he was a big, strong man too.
If I lose you tonight, my love, will I ever know the ache in you? Will your soul soothe all the toil in you, my love? Will the pain ever soften? If I
wanted to stand in Galway ground and sing my heart out. So yeah, I wanted to do all the singing on its own. It's an unusual way to go about it, to sing first without any music. My last album, Pages, I recorded the orchestra first and then did all the singing afterwards. So for this one, I wanted to give singing a lot of space. You remember my grandmother?
Of course I do, yeah. Annie Joyce, Annie Feeney. She was Joyce from Currantarmuid, like you make.
Okay, yeah. And when my grandparents would come for a visit?
Oh yes, I remember that well too. They'd be waiting for the moonlight night. This was their saying anyway, that they'd be waiting till the moon is up, full moon, and they'd have light.
Really?
That's nice, yeah.
Wondering what it's going to be like. What a fantastic day, a marvelous wonder. What a great day, what a fantastic day. Hey, what a great day, what a fantastic day. A marvelous wonder. What a great day, what a fantastic day. Hey, hey, hey.
Waiting on a moonlight night.
What it's going to be like.
Waiting on a moonlight night.
Wondering. wondering what it's going to be like.
Waiting on a moonlit night.
Wondering what it's going to be like.
Waiting on a moonlit night.
What is going to be
and
like?
I revelled in a spell of a beating, pleasing stroke of a country air.
And what is going to be
and
like?
I revelled in a spell of the echoes, lamb to hush of the velvet pair.
And what is going to be
and
like?
And I revelled in a spell of a beating, pleasing stroke of the country air.
And what is going to be
and
like?
I revelled in a spell of the echoes, lamb to hush of the velvet pair.
And what is going to be like?
What a fantastic.
Out in a beautiful Galway church. And I looked at a few, and when I went in with my mother actually into Kylemore Abbey, into the visitor centre, and from the get-go, from first second, they were extremely nice and extremely interested and extremely positive. And the Benedictine nuns, they have a fantastic attitude to life. Kylemore Abbey is a wonderful, wonderful place. Mitchell Henry was a very, very wealthy man, and he got engaged to his wife in Kylemore, and they went on their honeymoon there. And when his wife died at a very young age, tragically, he built Kylemore Abbey Gothic Church in her honour. It's just such a beautiful thing to do.
So what was Edward like?
He was a nice man. White man, I'd say. He was witty, but witty man too.
When Julia died, after Julia had died, his wife, you remember, my grandmother, somebody asked him, would he sing a song? They said he had a beautiful voice. And he said, oh, sure, I don't have anything to sing about.
The missus is gone.
Yeah.
I see. Sad enough, sure.
Yeah.
Tonight, waiting in the water, Julia, Julia, and I cry out to the river.
Decided to get back to an email that I had received from David Reitzes that I hadn't. It just seems so bizarre that, you know, somebody was driving their car in LA and heard me on the radio, because everyone in LA listens to radio. They're all in their cars all the time. And he heard me, he listens to Bob Edwards all the time, loves the show, and wrote an email to me straight away saying that he offered to mix a track for free. I wrote to Dave and I said, you know, actually, would you be interested in mixing the whole album? And he immediately, absolutely, yes. And he's so busy. So actually, the last night when we took the photograph, you know, some people don't like doing those photographs, but it was fun to do it in this like beautiful studio and arms around one another like that, you know. And guess what? There was an earthquake. Deadly serious. And he said the last time he was in an earthquake, he was in a studio, he was with Prince, and then he said this time he was with me, so I don't know, whatever that means. Is there another Feeney that I hadn't heard about who's...
You haven't heard anything about Brother Feeney, have you?
Brother Feeney? No, I never even knew about him.
Is that right? Oh, he's an old man now, but he's still playing it.
And how would I get in touch with him?
Well, sure, his nephew, Sean. No problem.
Right.
No problem. And he'll get you his number, I suppose. I thought you might have it, no, to be
honest. I didn't even know about him. That's amazing.
Didn't you?
No.
Well.
How do you describe them?
Oh, they were hard-working people and very thrifty people. They all got on very well. And especially John Feeney's family, the mother died when they were children, you see.
Yeah.
So, oh, they were. There were no fools, I can tell you.
I found a lot of very interesting people in my family tree. And there's always... There are great men and there are great women as well. And I think in every family, you'd see there's going to be some tricky men, and then there's going to be the great women that hold it all together.
She was serene if there were wigs in a green. When it was complicated, she let them be. But she ruled as easy as water off a little duck's back for posterity. She built a sanctuary. She sings Galway. I dream with you. By night I fly with you. Miracles I wish for you. I'm spinning always round you. Ever tender tears for you. Ever fastening for you. Ever standing tall for ever my boy from Galway.
I learned so much from Dave. I'm completely in awe of him. Just a complete gent and generous and just amazing. Actually, my friends go, David, like this, David, like this. Because I'm always, David, David. Because I came home and I wouldn't shut up talking about him. But, He's cool. He's very cool.
Where else did you look around for the records? And
I went to the Births, Deaths and Marriages office.
Oh, yeah.
I also went to the Galway West Genealogical Society. And there's a lady who knows you, actually, in there.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Is she nice?
She's very nice. She's very nice, and she's nice things to say.
I'm on, yeah.
About you down here.
Spell of the echoes, then to hush the velvet.